Anthony, we know you work for Jed.
We know that he called you from here. We know that he spoke in code. We got it on tape.
I know you're gonna lie for your boss, which is admirable. Gives you cred, maybe promotion when he gets out.
Except he's not getting out. He's going away for murder. Question is, are you going down with him?
What did the code mean?
It meant there's some tight-ass woman cop who works up here and needs...
Hey! Show some respect, asshole.
How's your sis? Teaching school in Sudbury with her juvie record sealed. I used to work there. Every time we saw each other, she looked so scared I would out her. How would it go over if it got out that she was involved in a home invasion gone so violently wrong?
That wasn't her. I was the one who...
What was Jed telling you to do?
So I was at this bar, and I got talking with this Tom Mask guy. I'd seen him there before. This time he was being all weird, going on about this girl.
Look, Alex, I didn't fly across the country to gab. Get to the point.
The girl was Carol Miller.
Carol Miller?
Yeah. And he said flat out that he killed her. He said he stabbed her 5 times. And that he ate a grapefruit and threw it on her.
Why the hell would this masked guy admit that to you?
It was like he was confessing to me. Like he needed to unload.
Like you need a plea deal.
Yeah, okay. I want a deal. But it ain't right been going on with all them girls. This guy needs to be stopped.
I hope for your sake, Alex, you're not wasting my time.
Trust me. You're gonna thank me.
Alex knew things. He knew about the stab wounds, the grapefruit, the orchid.
Belchi! We are very much happy you are playing again. This is our gift to you. Sandwich. This is you upon receipt of sample.
Smiling?
Happy cartoon.
Fucking A, man. That feels fucking right. We needed this, man. You two fucking buffoons are standing there with your giant dicks. I mean, that's a fucking sturgeon, man. Jesus Christ. I tell you, man, I always think you're gonna fucking prank me or whatever, you know, or you're gonna say your shit about my fucking mom, which, you know.
No. We respect your mother now. She's...
Come on, get him in ya.
All the drinks in this country taste like piss.
Taste like a Kazakh shit in my mouth.
All these kisses.
I will love your baby.
Thank you so much. It's so nice.
Martin Ward, RCMP. I need to see an official. It's regarding a very important and delicate matter.
Everything is important, sir. Take a blue number, take a seat right there. Somebody will be with you shortly.
No papers, no numbers today. I want to speak to your boss.
It's protocol. You need an appointment.
Hey, qu'est-ce que tu comprends pas d'emergency?
Sir, lower your voice.
We should sign his dick. Yes. Everyone sign his dick.
What's happening here?
What's the matter? You have a little puss-puss?
Mommy whipped up a pussy pot pie, huh?
Let's see what's going on over there.
Show us your dick.
I don't want you to see my dick.
Why are you being gay?
I think you're fucking being pretty gay.
It's not gay.
Not if you're brothers.
If you're brothers, it's gay with a fucking dash of something else.
My brother's gay and he doesn't even do that.
I've been playing hockey my whole life. I never fucking signed no one's dick, man.
All you pinko Bolshevik ass eaters, man!
This bitch ball. Because you cannot even stop a fucking beach ball.
Not nice!
Beach ball is bigger than puck. That's why joke is.
Yeah, I fucking get it, man.
Thank you for seeing us.
I'm not clear why the chief of staff is requesting a visit for his father.
The White House has a strong interest in your child's welfare.
There's an emergency custody hearing scheduled.
Until that's resolved in Mr. Walker's favor, he's not allowed to visit.
Are you just gonna keep him locked up? Can you imagine how scared he is?
According to our doctors, the boy is doing just fine. Settling in nicely.
Settling into what exactly? What is this place?
A Department of Humanity facility.
You know, I got that. What is going on here? Why are there doctors? Is it a hospital? Is it a research center? I mean, what are you doing to him?
We're taking care of him.
I'm sorry. Who here knows how to do that? Do you know what his favorite cereal is? Or when it's time to check his blood sugar? What scares him? What about his mom? What do you say when he asks about her?
He's a 6-year-old boy. He's been taken away from his father. No matter what your doctors are saying, he can't be doing just fine. At least let Mr. Walker go in and explain to the boy what's going on.
Policy is policy, Miss Keller.
Think about it, Carl. Is it absolutely impossible that you could be one of them?
At this point, the defense your lawyer is suggesting is probably your best option.
Just confess. Plead insanity. Or else you're going away for a very long time. Maybe even worse. You don't want that, do you?
Get me out of here! Back up, Doc, or I'll rip this frog to shreds!
Just settle down, Carl. We can talk about this. Let your lawyer go.
It's a fucking frog! A fucking frog! I'm all talked out. I want out, or he dies.
There's no need to hurt anybody. Listen to me, Carl. What you perceive as the frog is a hallucination.
No. No, that's not possible. It can't be.
Your mind is playing tricks on you. You feel what your mind believes to be real, however it is not. You have to believe me.
No. You have to believe me. I'll prove to you that this is just a stupid animal.
Do it, Fischer, and I'll drill a bullet in your brain.